Hi guys, welcome or welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be showing you guys my Bath & Body Works empties for the month of September. So I know it's a little bit late, but yes, as always, I'm just going to jump right in and get started in no particular order. So the very first item I used up, please don't mind that it looks so gross. This is Saltwater Breeze, the body scrub. Yes, the packaging got all gross and started flaking off in the shower, but the scent and the formula of the scrub was so nice. So this is the very first product I've ever purchased and tried in Saltwater Breeze, and it was actually extremely nice. It's definitely like very like oceanic scent. You get like the hint of like saltiness. It's really, really good. And then the scrub is nice too. It's got like a nice like lather and everything. I would 100% repurchase this. Next up, I do have a hand soap. This is the Foaming Soap in Autumn Pumpkin. I do really like this packaging. It's like kind of like simplistic, but also very nice. It's like the black with the orange. This scent was really nice. It reminds me of the candle pumpkin pie in like soap form. Yeah, it was really good. This came out a couple years ago. I do still have one more in my collection, and if they bring this back out, I would definitely repurchase it. Next up, I have another soap. This is the Exfoliating Hand Soap in Toasted Vanilla Chai. Again, this is from a couple years ago at this point. I do really like this scent as well. I feel like I've seen the scent return. Obviously not in this like same package or what have you, but this is a really nice scent as well. I'm noticing though that the exfoliating soap is not my favorite. My favorite's definitely like the Nourishing or like, I don't even know the name, but yes. So this formula is not my favorite, but again, I would definitely rebuy it for the scent. It's almost like I want like a drink like this, like a coffee that smells and tastes like I would imagine this too. Next up, I did finish. This is the set of Agave Papaya Sunset. I have the lotion, the shower gel, and the body spray. This is a really nice scent as well. Well, okay, you guys know I'm just gonna say that about everything, but yes, this reminds me of like a sweet, fruity, like a candy of some kind. Yeah, this is really good. I did not get sick of it, surprisingly, so I would definitely repurchase that as well. Next up, I did finish up, this is a room spray in Grapefruit Gin Fizz. This is pretty old. I wanna say like 5 years old is when the scent came out. I did really like this. I do really enjoy grapefruit scents, and I feel like Bath & Body Works doesn't really make too many of them. So yeah, if I could find this again, I would definitely repurchase it as well. Although it is like very, very like summery. Next up, I have a travel size Beautiful Day body spray and the Beautiful Day body cream. This was in my purse. Now, of course, I'm into like a much more like pumpkin-y scent for my bag. But yeah, this is like a fresh, like slightly like floral scent with mostly apples. I definitely like this. I always get compliments when I wear this too. So yeah, this is like a fresh spring day. And I would definitely repurchase it. I like anything with apples. Next up, I do have some pocket bags. First up, this is Unicorn Milkshake. This is, again, a couple years old as well. This one, like to me, it's very, very sweet. And when one of my friends pointed out that it kind of reminds her of root beer, and like now when like I put it on too, it also kind of reminded me of root beer as well. It's quite interesting. It doesn't say like what exact scent Unicorn Milkshake is supposed to smell like. It's very, very sweet. I would pick one up again. It wasn't like my favorite thing ever, but I would get it again if I could find it. Next up, this is Black Cherry Merlot pocket bag. You see, I had this problem in my last video too. I feel like there's definitely one more use, so I'm gonna have to tip it upside down and get it out. Anyways, though, Black Cherry Merlot, this is not my favorite scent in pretty much anything, but I do occasionally enjoy it in a hand soap and a pocket bag. So yeah, I would get it again in pocket bag form. Next up, another pocket bag. This is in Crisp Morning Air. This is different from the candle. I don't like the candle. It's like definitely like a very masculine candle, but in the soap and the pocket bag, it's a lot more like clean and fresh. So yeah, I would get it again. It's not like amazing or anything like that, but overall I would repurchase it. Next up, I did finish up. This is the Berry Waffle Cone scent portable for the car. This was pretty good. It wasn't as strong or long lasting as I envisioned, just because this in like candle form is like really intense. So it was okay. Then again, like the car scents, in my opinion, are always like pretty like hit and miss and everything like that. So I probably wouldn't purchase it again in this particular like scent portable, just because I do enjoy other ones better and I tend to have better luck with other ones. But it wasn't bad. Next up, this is not Bath & Body Works, but I thought I would include it. You guys know I've said it before, I'm obsessed with Burt's Bees chapstick. That's like my like ultimate favorite brand for chapstick. This is in the watermelon flavor. It was really nice, very summery. Next up, I also have, this is from Aromatherapy Peaceful Tea Tree and Peppermint, the lotion. I did put this in my guest bathroom just to like put on like lotion after I wash my hands and everything like that. It's very refreshing, very minty, but not like overly minty. Not like twisted peppermint, like that like level of mintiness. I did like it though. I would consider repurchasing it. I do still have the shower gel, but to be honest, I prefer the lotion over the shower gel. I don't know why, but yes. I also think the bottle is really pretty as well. Next up, I do have, this is the Christmas Cookies Body Cream. I did cut it. I don't always like cut open my body creams. In fact, I don't usually cut them open just because I feel like I have like so many other like products to get through and everything like that. But I was really enjoying this. This honestly just smells like a buttery sugar cookie. Like, I don't even know how else to describe it. This was delicious. So good. I'm happy that I have a couple more of this scent in my collection, and I would definitely repurchase this. I like when like they're like cut because they look so like stout and like chubby and cute. Anyways, next up, I did finish up. This is the Sugar Berry Smash. This is like old. Like this is like 7 years old now. Anyways, yeah. So like their bottles haven't even looked like this in like forever. This was like the kind like you could unscrew and everything like that. This one reminds me of like a scent that Victoria's Secret Pink used to carry. It's like a very sweet, almost like cotton candy-ish scent. I don't know if it was like going bad or not, but I felt like to me, I didn't love it quite as much as I used to love it when I very first purchased it. And also, it didn't like linger on my skin as long as I feel like it used to. So yeah, this is really old and I just wanted to get it out of my collection, but it was nice. Next up, I have some wallflowers. The first one, this is in Harvest Gathering. This was actually the best performing wallflower that I did use up this month. Harvest Gathering is like a very like fall scent. Like it's like spicy, and says it has apples, autumn berries, and clove buds. It's definitely like a spicy apple. It's very like seasonally appropriate for fall. It was strong and it did stay strong pretty much until the end. So this one had good performance. And to me, wallflowers are like very hit and miss. Next up, and this is lemon mint leaf. See, so for example, I was thinking that this one would be strong, but honestly, this one was pretty weak. Even after, I want to say after like the third day, I could not smell it, which is really bizarre because this is like a really strong scent. So overall, I would probably not repurchase lemon mint leaf wallflower. I mean, of course, this particular wallflower is like a couple years old. I could just tell by like the tag and everything. So I might or might not. I really do enjoy the fragrance, but this particular bulb was not very good. Next up, again, another like dud in wallflower form. This was Angel Food Cupcake. Again, this was just like a really like a sweet vanilla scent. It wasn't anything like super special or anything like that. But this scent in wallflower was very light. It was not long lasting. I couldn't smell it for more than a couple days. So overall, I would not recommend or repurchase this particular wallflower. Next up, this wallflower also did really well. This is Autumn. And again, all of these wallflowers are like, I could tell by the tags that they're like a couple years old. Autumn was a really good one though. It's like a really fresh apple scent. So yeah, this one actually, it's like yay mush left in the bottle. It's in my kitchen. So yeah, so this one was actually really good. I would definitely repurchase Autumn in a wallflower. So I do have a couple candles. Actually, yeah, I have quite a few candles. So candles, and then I'm gonna do a couple Lush items just because I happen to use them up. So the first candle I used up, this is Pumpkin Pecan Waffles. Yeah, everyone knows this one. It's really strong. It's like a very like bakery, really just super strong scent. This particular package is from a couple years old. For some strange reason, this candle got like super sooty, like where like the wax got discolored and all like stuff like that, which I thought was like, odd. I mean, just because, like, I know sometimes the candles get sooty, but this was, like, badly sooty. But anyways, I would continue to repurchase this scent, although I generally just pick up, like, one for the year because it is very strong, and it's like, you know, just one is good for me every fall. Next up, I do have, this is Twisted Peppermint. Yeah, the label, when I was burning it too, I don't know if you guys have ever like experienced this, but like when I was burning the candle, like the label started like cracking and peeling on the outside, so I just like peeled it off completely. Honestly though, this candle sucked. The performance of this candle was like the worst ever. Like, okay, like the wicks kept like drowning and everything like that. Sorry that the glass is like so like dirty and stuff too. Yeah, the wicks kept drowning, and even when I kept like trying to like fix it and everything like that, it never corrected itself. I really should have taken it back to the store, but then I felt like by the time I like thought about it, it was already like super empty. I do really like the scent though, almost like more so in the summer. And the lid's really cute as well, just because it's really refreshing. So I definitely would repurchase the scent, but not in this particular package, which is fine because this package is old. So I'm sure it's just that particular candle, but that was awful. Next up, I do have, this is Autumn. This candle is from this current fall that we're in. This one was really nice. I had no issues with it. It was a good, clean, strong burn. This is a really classic scent for fall. I would definitely recommend it. Yeah. Next up, this is Chestnut and Clove. Again, this is definitely a couple years old. I wanna say this is also in like the 6 or 7 year old mark at this point. The lid is nice and festive on it. It says love fall. This reminds me of Thanksgiving. I only ended up even burning this one just because I do have another one in my collection, and it was already like at like the halfway mark, so I just wanted to like finish it and get it out. This one says it has warm roasted chestnut, fresh ground clove, and cedar wood. I don't know why, like this one's pretty spicy without being like too spicy, but this almost like reminds me of like a craft store. It's just very like Thanksgiving-ish to me. I do like this scent though. I would definitely repurchase it again. And again, I had no problems with the burn on this one as well. Next up, I have, this is Eucalyptus Mint. You guys know I've said it before, this is one of my favorite scents of all time. I think the packaging is really nice. Yeah, don't mind that there's still like 2 wicks in there. I just gave up and could not get them out. They were like stuck. Anyways, this is a really wonderful scent. It's super clean, it's really relaxing, very refreshing. I highly recommend this. Again, I had no issues with the burn and would definitely repurchase. Next up, I do have, this is Strawberry Pound Cake. Everyone knows this one. This is delicious. Yeah, I think the packaging's really adorable. The lid's really nice as well. I do still have a couple more of these. This was wonderful. I had no problems, no issues with the burn or anything like that. I would definitely recommend and definitely repurchase this one. Next up, I have, this is White Tea and Sage. This one I wasn't sure, like, if I would like, because it's almost like a little too like bathroomy, but it was actually really pleasant. It definitely gives me like spa type vibes. It was definitely like a medium scent though. You could definitely like detect it even like throughout my entire apartment, everything like that. So yeah, I actually was pleasantly surprised by this one. I didn't think I would love it as much as I ended up loving it. So I would definitely repurchase this in the future. Next up, this is my last 3 wick. Next up, we have my beloved pumpkin pie. This is, I don't know if it's from last year or the year before. I believe it's the year before. Yeah, I was, you know, holding on to this for a long time because I wasn't sure if they would bring it back, but then they brought it back this year under a different name. So, of course, now I was able to burn this. Yeah, so this is really good. This is honestly one of my very favorite candles for fall. It smells like legit exactly like this photo. Exactly just like a pumpkin pie. Like you get your sweet, you get a little bit of spicy. It's just so delicious. So yeah, I would 100% recommend this. And again, I had no issues with the burn. Good clean burn, good, pretty strong, everything like that. I would definitely repurchase that. And then I do have, the small candle. So this is Cucumber Melon. I did, picked this up not that long ago either at an SAS. Yeah, this smells just like, it's like a fresh, like watery type of like cucumbery scent. It's not like amazing or anything like that. It wasn't very strong, but that's fine. This size candle never really is for me. So I did end up putting this in my bedroom, and you know, it's pretty good. I don't think I would repurchase it just because now I've had it. It's more like a one and done, but I am glad that I did try it. And then my last candle, this is in Pumpkin Cupcake. Again, this is from a couple years old. Maybe it's just from last year. Please don't mind that noise in the background if you guys can hear that. That's my cat. Yeah, Pumpkin Cupcake is a wonderful scent. I don't really smell much pumpkin. It's more like a, just like a very vanilla with like a little bit of like spice in there. It's really nice. I would definitely burn this year round. Actually though, this particular candle was a little bit disappointing. There is like a lot of like wax left up on the sides. And just in general, this particular candle took, it kept having like puny wick syndrome, which to me rarely happens with the one wick candles. So that was kind of disappointing. And it was also very, very light. Like even in my bedroom, it was still very light. Yes, that is it for my Bath & Body Works. I'm quickly going to do the couple random and the couple lush in case you guys are interested. So first up, I did finish up. This is a Zoom and Go Natural Spa at Home. I don't even remember what scent this in. My sister gifted this to me literally years ago. I think she got it from Whole Foods. But yeah, this was nice. I don't even know like what like type of scent it was. I think it was like a minty scent. Yeah, it's very minty. This is just like good for like sore muscles and everything like that. I'll sometimes like pair it with like a bath bomb or bubble bars or bubble bath and everything like that. But yeah, this was a good product. I would consider repurchasing it. Next up, I know I've showed you guys this before too. This is my everyday sunscreen in Olay facial sunscreen and antioxidants. I use this all the time. I highly recommend it. It's really good. And then the last items are some Lush. So first up, this is a fresh face mask in Cosmetic Warrior. I've actually never tried these before, and I was gifted this and the other fresh face mask that I have. This is pretty good. It just has have a very odd smell. I wouldn't purchase it just because I didn't notice like a drastic difference in my skin. But it does like take out like some of like the redness and everything like that. And regardless, it does feel nice on the skin. These, in case you guys don't know, but these are very, if you bring back 5 of like your black pots, you are able to redeem them for a fresh face mask for free. So that's like a really nice perk. Yeah, overall, like this mask didn't make like a huge, huge difference, but it was like, you know, like a nice little like pick me up and a nice like way to relax and everything. So the smell is very odd though. It's definitely like a very garlicky smell and even like the texture. Yeah. Next up, again, another fresh face mask. This is in the fresh face mask called Cupcake. This one smelled delicious. It looked exactly like a brownie batter or something like that. It smells just like chocolate. This one was really nice. It was very like soothing and like cooling on the skin almost. Also because you have to keep these in your fridge. But yeah, this one was super refreshing to use. This one I actually noticed more of a difference than this one. Again, I don't really think I would actually go out and purchase these of my own accord. I would rather just like purchase other things and then, you know, be able to redeem these as a free one. But I would definitely pick up Cupcake in the future. So, and then the very last item I have, this is Bucks Fizz body conditioner. A body conditioner is basically you take a shower, you wash yourself, and then you put on a body conditioner after you you let it sit for like a couple minutes out of like the direct line of water, and then you just rinse off and then you just pat yourself dry. So I actually really love the Lush body conditioners. To me, like this is what I use if I'm like going somewhere in a rush and I know I don't have any time to like put lotion on and let it like sink in. This scent is like a really it's like a fruity orangey scent. It kind of reminds me of Champagne Toast with like quite a bit more orange in it. But yeah, it's really nice. I would definitely highly recommend the Lush body conditioners, and the Bucks Fizz scent is just a really nice fruity orange scent. So as always, thank you guys for watching. Stay tuned because very soon I will also be posting. I'm going to be doing a Bath & Body Works declutter. I don't think it's going to be anything like too like massive or anything like that, but yeah, I'm just feeling like quite overwhelmed in my collection, and I'm also going to be moving soon, so yeah, I just really need to work on like shrinking my stash and everything like that. So as always, thank you guys for watching. Bye.